Welcome to Spank and Jake!
Pew 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 pew.
Wait, no.
Okay.
This is my job. Welcome to Spank and Jake. I'm Travis.
It's your job?
Dun dun dun
yeah,
dun.
Yeah, last time I was on, I introduced this.
But
so it's my job.
The
now.
Last time you did this, I also reminded you that it's not called the Spank and Jake podcast.
Oh, yeah,
it's the Hey We're Friends podcast.
Oh, yeah, this is the Hey We're Friends podcast. Whatever
hosted
I'm
by
Spank
and Jake.
It's the Spank and Jake podcast hosted by Hey We're Friends.
You've got it completely.
What if, like, when Jacob threw his phone, like, what if it landed on Travis's forehead?
Well, that was the idea to make you all think.
Well, that's what I wanted. I realized
make
that's
all
what
believe
I wanted.
That I was going to abuse him.
I am not his father.
Who's? No one's his father. No one thought
we're all his owners.
You're right.
That's just how it is.
That's the way of the gerbil.
Yep.
Because he is the grenade.
I'm eating.
Yes, we can hear the bag.
In case anyone's curious.
No one's really curious. All right.
Okay. Welcome to the Hey We're Friends podcast.
Thank you.
This is episode 14.
It is.
Mm-hmm. We have the return of our co-host, Jacob.
You mean Chase.
Welcome back.
And Chase.
Chase. I just slapped him. Tonight's guest,
You'll
we
see.
Have Travis.
Hey. Travis.
We're
Chase.
Your beard feels nice, Chase.
What?
Your beard feels nice when I slapped you.
Dude, I've been conditioning it with my vanilla conditioner.
Oh my god.
It works.
You
know.
Thank you.
Alright, we have Chase.
Jacob.
And Matt.
Hello.
Jacob.
And how's everybody doing so far?
Me okay.
I'm trying to eat.
Eat just a bad time. So...
So,
you guys want to hear about my work?
Why not?
Tell us
I did
about
some pretty sly stuff.
You did some sly stuff.
So, for those who don't know, I'm a market clerk / market wrapper. I work in a meat market at Super One. And we have to take everything out of the cooler to put it onto the shelves so people can buy it, because they can't buy it from the back. Because that's what they say anyway.
This is crawfish tails.
Yes, they have to ask, and we can get it from the back. But anyway.
Weird.
Well, people stole them a lot.
Oh.
I don't know why, but, well, I mean, I guess because it's expensive. Yeah, crawfish tails are expensive. Anyway, so we have these big racks that have 8 shelves, and on each shelf we have a big pan. Like, imagine a cookie pan, but bigger, and that's where we store all our meat when we're not putting it onto the display case. Well, at the end, like, when the shelf, or when the rack is empty, we're supposed to grab all the pans and put them in one spot. Anyway. I was stacking them onto one shelf on the rack, and I tossed a pan in, and it slid through one side and slid right out the other, and I quickly grabbed it, and I caught it, and I looked up, looked around, and one of my coworkers staring at me, and he just stuck his thumb up, and he was like, yeah. I was really happy. And I was like, I'm so glad someone saw, because, like, I feel like no one would believe me, even though it's a very possible thing to happen. And then today, I was throwing boxes into the air, and I slid a box in, like, super perfectly. And I got excited.
Like, was it like one of those kind of like Jenga type fits?
Like, it was a big stack of boxes with ground meat inside, and I had like the size of the box plus a couple more inches before you hit the ceiling, and I just like grabbed it without really looking and tossed it up and it went in. Oh! And then I had a water bottle earlier today, and I like stared one of my coworkers down, and I like did a hook shot without it looking, and it landed in the trash can really far away, and I was like, ooh, kill him.
Where's the chat?
Oh, yeah, we didn't put that up.
I've got it here.
Window. Chat.
Boom.
Okay. And now you could full screen on something.
Man, I have to say, we're looking awfully professional today.
Oh, yeah, we have more equipment than we did the last podcast.
Yeah, like, we have...
The last
we
podcast.
We have 2 computers running right now. One's on the table, one's to the side with our topic list, as well as our chat. We have 2 new mics, an interface that I brought, another mic stand that we were going to use.
Everyone take note that I brought it.
He's trying to be everyone.
Yeah, Jacob brought it.
Chase.
Yeah, okay, everyone's Jacob. Jacob brought it.
I'm Jacob.
I'm Jacob.
No, it's just me who's Jacob.
No,
he's
Jacob,
and Jacob
does
that.
I'm Jacob. That's Jacob. That's not Jacob.
He says, pointing at Chase and wait. Jacob,
yeah,
and not Jacob.
Yeah, we so need a video camera.
This one's really tender too.
Oh talking about his beef jerky.
All right, so Jacob has, what, barbecue boneless wings?
Yeah.
And Chase has some beef jerky.
I want to hit this table so bad. Mm. I'm trying not to.
Oh, I can't even, I can't do anything to the table this time because I'm so far away from this.
Yeah. You know, I'm so happy.
Yep.
So.
Wait. But Chase is still telling a story?
No. I was going to ask a question.
I thought Travis was leading into something.
Oh. Well, while we're on the topic of microphones.
No, I was like, how much more advanced we are. Like, we've got the laptop on the desk running chat. We've got the computer over there running chat, Mixlr, and the topics list.
Mixlr.
The audio interface that's actually being used.
In a way, you're kind of saying, like, Mixlr.
Mixlr.
And it makes sense because no one really says it right.
Okay.
You slur through it anyway.
the audio interface we're actually using, the one we're not using, two 2020s, and then a mic and a mic stand we're not using.
That I brought.
We don't have
Go Travis!
Bringing useless stuff.
But yeah, we're actually using two mics on this podcast, and hopefully everybody sounds clearer and more picked up.
Travis might sound
hurtling in front of one single mic.
Yeah, so, which is nice. Which means we can be on opposite sides of the table, so we're not all crowded on the same side.
Yeah, yeah. Like this is a really first.
It doesn't feel as hot yet. It probably helps.
Yeah.
It'll get hotter on our side because of me. Because
you're so hot, Travis.
So sexy.
What are you staring at?
Oh, who's that?
Who are you asking?
Who's Brent?
That's my dad.
Matt's dad.
Oh,
cool. We have a.
He was on the last. Like he was.
And he was harassing me
podcast.
The entire time.
He was.
Yeah, it was a bit amusing.
So I wanted to ask, and it will lead into my story about the old people.
About the old people.
I mentioned it while we were recording, Spank and Jake. Something I wanted to bring up during the podcast.
Oh, okay.
And he posted it on Facebook.
Yeah, when I shared it. Nice.
We both
back swiped at it or backhanded towards the fly. Anyway, is there anything like that happens at work frequently enough for you to like consider it a thing that happens at work that really, really bothers you? And if so, tell me a story.
Okay, I understand what is.
For example, you could tell me about your assistant manager who's stupid.
Oh,
oh my god!
I wouldn't call her the assistant manager. Like she's more like the lead of a specific department, and
so like a manager of your department.
Yeah, yeah, it's pretty much. But they won't give her the title of lead.
Good, she doesn't deserve it.
Nah, customers. Oh my god, she wastes so much time.
Customers insist on asking for assistance at the Super One that I work at. Whenever I'm sweeping the floors, like with two big dust mops, like going down the aisles. I kind of have to, like... There's usually no place for me to put them so I can help them. And, it's really... it's so annoying. So, like, there's another guy. Like,
I mean,
ask him. Like, ask the other guy that's stalking because he's more likely able to help you in a timely manner. Whereas I have to go and put these dust mops somewhere.
You can just set them against one of the shelves?
I could.
Do you like take the time to walk them all the way back into the warehouse?
No, they're in the, like if I'm at the end of an aisle, I'll put it on the end cap. But if like I just put it in the middle of the aisle, it's in the way.
I know what you wanted to say, by the way, Chase.
I haven't told you about it?
Yeah, we talked about it when we went visit Cody.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Yes.
Okay, so what is that story?
You want to hear it?
Yeah, I want to hear it. I have no clue what you're talking about.
For whatever reason, I've had issues with old women touching me while I'm at work.
What?
And I'm completely serious. And it's never like...
That's a thing that happens?
Yes. And the only reason I can justify it, because it makes no sense to like do whatever I'm about to explain, is they're old women and it's like their way of like, ooh, a young boy, I touched his arm. Ooh.
How old are these ladies?
At least 60.
Okay.
It's happened with like 3 different ladies so far.
So they're like all old enough to be a grandmother.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
You're so strong.
Exactly. They're old enough to sound like that. So basically, because I work in a market, my body is cold because I'm in a very cold climate, except when I walk out onto the floor. And even then, on the floor, like, I've heard customers talk about how cold it is around the market area, which is really weird because, like, I don't know. It's just not to me.
It's probably because you're, like, accustomed to, like, working in the cold. So as when well you're, like cold. Not in as cold of an area,
it's, like, nothing.
Yeah.
It's funny because my assistant manager, he used to ask me how, like, all I'd wear was my apron and my work shirt. And he's like, how is it you don't need a hoodie or a coat? And I was like, real men don't need it. And anyway, it was funny. But so this lady one time came up to me. We have like this little reduced section. And she was just looking at it, picking it up. And like, she just started talking to me and like standing really, really close. Like I backed up and she just got close again. I'm like, whatever, I'm much taller than you. So it's not like you can like attack my face with your face or anything. So she randomly just like puts her hand on me and like, in that voice, can you please say, your arms are so cold?
No, I have food in my mouth.
But once you're done, can you go tell
me? Your arms are so cold. Man, if I could do it like a Brooklyn accent, you know.
Come on. I'm trying. No.
So, as you imagine, this is Jacob's an old lady. He's about to touch my arm and feel how cold my arm is.
I'm still chewing.
Come on, man.
Matt's dad wants you to put the bag down.
Really?
Yeah.
Deal with it.
and then says that the young ladies are planning for their retirement
call
years.
Call it Goodwill Hunting. Put the chip bag down, boy.
It's not chips.
Put the bag.
It says the chip bag down. So anyway, yeah.
We'll get you a bag of chips.
Wait, what did you want me to say?
Your arms are so cold.
Your arms are so cold.
Sounds so perfect.
Basically, that's what they do, and they like squeeze it tighter, and they're like, "Feel how warm my hand is compared to your arm." And I'm like, "Just get off of me."
It's so weird.
It really
but
is
you can't.
Weird.
You can't. You
exactly,
can't say
you can't
it.
Say.
Yeah.
You can't say anything about it. It's just like really odd. Like, and I'm like, I'm gonna be a professional about it, so I'm just like, yeah. And like, I kind of slowly mosey on so they get the idea that, hey, I'm trying to get back to work without being too rude about it. And it's happened with other people too. And it's just weird. Because like, even before I worked at Super One, it's happened before. And like, I don't know why, as women age, they're just like,
touch you.
Yeah, I grabbed
you. You made it sound like she was trying to take your soul.
So there's this one lady who is nuts. Like, it is so weird. She has fiery red-orange hair, and she's old as well, and, like, she has these bright blue eyes that just, like,
pop out.
Hey!
Yeah, I can already see the contrast.
She talks to everyone inside the market all the time, and, like, I end up listening to her for, like, 15 minutes once. So every time I see her now, I just avoid her. No, like, I avoid her so hard that I needed to walk 6 feet backwards, but she was standing 3 feet behind me, so I walked like an extra 50 feet to walk all the way around.
Oh my god!
Because like, even though she's already talked to me that day, I know she'd talk to me again. So I'm just like, no.
Fuck it.
Yeah. So what happened most recently with her was she showed up and I saw her and I'm like, ugh, whatever. So like, I'm doing my thing, I'm just putting stuff into the case, and she walked up to me and she started feeling my face. And she's like,
"Who the fuck does that?"
Does bitch, nobody wants to lose her hand.
Does
that's
nobody
what.
Respect personal like, space?
Just, I don't know, dude.
She just didn't say anything. She just went straight for the face.
Well, like, as soon as she touched my face, she started talking. But still, like,
what?
It was still just, an excuse.
Like, I was just like, "Hey, how you doing?" She's like, "Oh, well, I'm fine." Like, she gets close, and Jacob, you're gonna be me. And she's like, "Oh, look at this facial hair. You need a beard guard." You know, my nephew used to do something like this. Yeah, he always wore a beard guard.
Oh, wow. I wish we had a camera in here.
When she first touched me, I, like, literally jumped and looked at her, and I'm like,
"What?
I will kill you in your sleep." This needs to stop. So, later on, like, I see her walking, and, like, this guy passes by, and she starts talking to him. I'm like, so he, like, she's married, like, has a boyfriend thing, but she won't leave anyone alone. And then I realized he was a stranger to her, and like, he was like bothered because she was like, "Oh, what are you cooking for dinner?" That's what made me think, oh, they must like know each other. They didn't. And then like, I see this lady walk into the market, And then, like, she happened to turn around. And from, like, at least 15 feet of distance, she was just like, what are you cooking tonight? And the lady was like, what? And she's like, what are you cooking tonight? And the lady just stared and was like, I don't know you. And I'm just like, oh, cool. And later, I asked my manager, and I was like, Mr. Darrell, how can you professionally get, like, a customer to stop touching you for whatever reason? Because, I mean, I can't just, like, run away, and I can't, like, tell them to stop exactly. And he tells me, well, you can't put yourself in a position to be touched like that. And I'm like, I was doing my job. I can't avoid that. And then,
sexual harassment, bro.
Yeah. He made a joke saying, like, oh, well, I mean, God just gave you that face. You have no, you can't change anything about that. So, like, I glared at him, like, that's probably why you don't have that problem. No, it was funny because the assistant manager, he's not dumb, but, like, sometimes it just takes him a moment to get jokes. He was staring at me, and then, like, a couple seconds later, like, his face lit up, and he started laughing really hard. And I'm like, oh, yeah, and I felt so cool. And then my manager looked back. He's like, yeah, I do. I don't have problems with old women touching my face, just the young ones. And I was just like, well played. Well played. But anyway, yeah, it's been really, really nuisancing.
See, I understand what you're talking about because there used to be this older gentleman who would come into my store, and the term weird does not begin to describe him accurately, to the point where at one point he came in and we were selling, now this CVS, it's not the nicest establishment, and we were selling, it was around Thanksgiving, we were selling fake, like, coon hats. And he asked if they were real. I said, no, it's just plastic and fake hair. And then he launches into a 10-minute story about how he walked outside his front door one day, found a run-over raccoon on the road, picked it up.
On his front door, but it was run over.
Picked it up, walked it back to his house, cooked it, ate it, and then proceeded to make a hat out of its hide. And then, as I started to ignore him more and more, he finally got the gist. So he then proceeded to steal our nail polish and paint his nails.
In the store?
In the store, like walking around painting his nails.
What?
Yeah.
Poor state. Was he ever, like, confronted? Like, what? How did the store deal with that?
I didn't know how to confront him, and he walked away from the counter, and at the time, like, not allowed to leave the counter. So I, like, notified my manager, and she was just like, I don't want to approach him. I said, why not? And she was like, I'm afraid he's going to lose it and stab me. Because, like, that's not the first time. He's also come into the store, looked one of my coworkers in the face, and said, you know, sexually, I'm into men, women, girls, boys, whales. I'll be into you. And that was probably the most awkward situation.
I wouldn't call it awkward. That's just plain creepy.
Yeah, that's really
creepy. Did you guess what his dad said about women touching?
No.
What?
It could be worse. Ask any priest.
Oh! Oh! Well.
What a hoot.
Oh, what a hoot. Matt's dad. Matt's dad.
That's odd.
You know, if we ever get, like, thousands of listeners, I'm banning his ass.
No. Why? Why not? Just his ass? Everything else can stay.
So, recently they had this very old man. He's at least 70, probably older. And, like, he came up to me and he's like, do you have sliced turkey? And because I'm, like, so used to dealing with, like, steaks and roast and stuff, like, in the actual market that we cut, I often forget about our deli meats, like our Landfrost, like sliced turkey they throw onto a sandwich or something. That's what he was looking for, but I didn't put that together. So I showed him, like, the only turkey things that we have is our turkey wings, our turkey necks, our smoked wings, smoked necks, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, hold on, I know you have it. And so he whips out his, like, flip phone.
Good thing naturally. It was a phone.
Yeah. I'll show you have the turkey. So, like, he calls some guy, and he's like, hey, they told me they don't have the turkey. And I was just like, oh, no. And he, like, looks at me, he's like, they want to talk to you. And I'm just like, I hope they're not as crazy as this man. So I take the phone, and, like, it sounds like his son or, like, his caretaker. It was a younger guy who, like, clearly wasn't old. And he's like, I'm just looking for deli meat. And I was like, oh, okay. So I'm like, I'm going to give the phone back to this man. So I'm like, here you go. And I, like, bring him over. And as soon as I bring him over, he's like, you got this? And I'm like, what about the turkey? He's like, I'm looking for Little Smokies. I was just like, all right. We have pork and we have beef and we have a mixture. And he's like, it doesn't matter. And I'm like, okay, all right. And he's like, wait, it does. And I'm like, okay, okay. And he calls that guy back. And, like, he gives me the phone again. I'm like, hey, you're looking for Little Smokies? And he's like, yeah. And I'm like, okay, which one would you like? He's like, it doesn't matter. Just put it in the bag. And I was like, okay. So I grab it, or put it in the basket, rather. So I toss it into the basket. No one can see the fact that my hand is holding a phone in imagination land, and I'm holding it to my ear. So I'm going to put this down. So and he physically did it
down. Are you still talking to us?
Yeah, but
it's nice for us.
Okay, so here's the phone in my hand again. So I'm like, all right. And, like, before I hand the phone back, he's like, wait, I also need some hot dogs. I'm like, why am I shopping for you? This is really weird at this point. But I'm like, whatever, because something was going on in the market that I just didn't feel like dealing with. So I was like, whatever. So he's like, I want 3 packs of hot dogs. And I'm like, all right. So I'm like, bye. And he's like, bye. So I hand it to the man. And I'm like, okay, here's this. And your friend said you wanted hot dogs. And I'm sitting there thinking, I could probably get this man to buy a lot of things right now. I'm just like, you need this and this and this and this.
You're going to, like, manipulate him.
Yeah. But he's like, all right, I want the ones that are a dollar. Because, like, he assumed that'd be the cheapest ones. I'm like, well, we have these for 77 cents. Really good prices. Super one, you guys.
Is it brand stuff?
Yeah, it is. It was a Bar S. But anyway, so, like, he gets it, and he's like, oh, and he, like, gets, like, 7, and he just tosses them in the basket, and I'm just like, all right. And I don't know why that happens a lot with customers, but, like, they'll ask for one thing, and as soon as I show them where it is, they're like, okay, where's this, without actually looking at the first thing I tried showing them, but whatever. Anyway. Yeah, they got some crazy-ass people. There's this one guy who, every time I see him, he's like, hey, good to see you. Been a long time, Bubba. I don't know him, though.
You know what? I just want to...
He said he's proud of me, by the way. Last time I saw him.
You know, he's a pretty cool guy.
I'll take this time to say I'm glad that the Super One in Abbeville, the people who shop there are a bunch of hard asses.
You're glad?
Why?
Because, like, I don't have to deal with that.
Oh, like, they're like, I can get this myself. I don't need no help.
Yeah,
kinda like,
but didn't you that's just nice. Say that, like, people ask you for help.
No, yeah, I mean, like to the extent that you're describing, when you have, like, people touching your face and
yeah, through. He hates it, but it doesn't happen as often as it seems to happen for you.
At mine, there's this old disabled man, like, his legs are gone. He's wearing fake legs, so he has to wear the thingy. I mean, he has to drive the thing around, like the
scooter,
handicap cart. And every time he comes in, like, he goes for the stuff, like, no one buys. Like, not food products, but, like, our plumbing stuff.
Whoa. Like, our... What type of plumbing stuff?
Like...
Because, I mean, if he's buying, like, bleach and rope, you might have a problem.
Who uses rope?
No, like, he buys, like...
Depends on how you're getting rid of the body.
To clean his toilet and stuff, I guess.
But he has no legs. He doesn't poop.
What? How does that make sense?
What?
No legs. Guess I can't shit.
Like, every time he comes in, I'm like, oh man, it's that guy. And because, like the second he sees someone, he's like, hey, bud, do you have this? And then, like, if you help him find it, because I don't know where that stuff is, because I never stock it. And almost no one else buys from there. So, like, I try my best to avoid him. The only time I ever get caught is when they're like, hey, there's a guy in the parking lot who needs one of the handicapped scooters. You need to bring that. And every time I walk in, I'm like, man, I shouldn't walk fast because he's probably going to ask for help. And if I walk fast, he'll probably be like, hey, I need some help. And every time he asks for help, you're literally finding his entire shopping list for him.
Oh. Because, like, I hate those people.
He's like, hey, bud, you have this? Okay, now I'm also looking for this after you find that. And, like,
Yeah, like, they'll ask you where something is, and once you explain, like, give them directions, they're just like, oh, well, I have other things I want to look for. Can you tag around and help me find these items? And you're just like, okay, if it's like one or two items, it's not that big of a deal. But then the whole fucking shopping cart?
Yeah. Like, I mean, he doesn't always get a lot of stuff.
Well, but I had a lady that I actually didn't mind when she would come in and ask me, because I shit you not, every time she'd come in once a week, I'd find everything on her shopping list for her, and I'd have to load it into her car for her.
Oh, that's another thing.
But she would always tip me.
How much?
Like, usually, like, an extra $10.
That's a lot. That's actually pretty nice.
And then, one time she was trying to sell, like, old records, and she didn't know how to use eBay. So I explained, like, you know, how to use it for the most part, and told her, you know, you should probably get, like, a nephew or something. And then she pulls two really old records that are worth, like, decent amount of money.
Out of,
like,
her pockets.
Out of her trunk, and just hands them to me. Two old Elvis records. Did you sell them? No, I'm keeping those fuckers. I love Elvis.
Like, there's like, and this is, like, more of a general thing in my stores. Like, there are people, and I normally don't mind it when the older people do it. It's like, they need help loading water into their car. Except the thing is, most of the time it's not old people.
No,
it's just people out of shape. And I'm like, come on, man. You can burn like a tenth of a calorie doing this. Like,
You could use it.
It's like, you loaded this fucker into your basket. Why do you need me to take it out and put it in your vehicle?
Like, one of the things that pissed me off so much at retail is how people would go with a shopping cart, get like two items, get it bagged, and still takes the fucking cart outside with them.
And it's like, you...
I just want to fucking slap them.
The only time I've ever been okay with that is, like, if a lady is, like, carrying her baby.
You, like, you have to be careful with, like... With the store water. Because the plastic it's wrapped in is really flimsy.
Yeah. It'll tear.
It'll rip. Oh, yeah. It's not like Dasani or Azarka packaging, because that shit's sturdy.
No, that shit, you need a buzz saw to get through.
Well, we're not indoors.
Dude, back in the gap.
So
I wish we were indoors. Get paid for this.
That's
that'd be nice.
That's
probably really that you said, Super One. That you said indoors.
No, I said endorsed, because then we get paid for this shit.
This is a good podcast before. I don't even have to say anything. Just chilling, listening to stories.
He literally just like, I'm the host that doesn't talk.
Hey, man.
I'm the Spanky.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Jacob.
That's why I'm Jacob and you're not.
Because he actually talks.
What? I talk
you're dead to me, Dad.
What? Oh.
What?
Whoa.
So there's this really, really obese lady. That's the end.
The end of her or the end of your story?
So, and then I ended her.
I've come across her twice now, and if you are standing in the market, there's a window to the seafood area. Like, so you see the back of the seafood stand. And everyone who's in a scooter, you can't see their heads. Like, no matter how tall they are. So, there's this one lady who buzzes. Because we have a ringer, like a little bell next to seafood. So, if you want assistance, you buzz it. We'll walk straight out. Like, hey, what's up? How can we help you? So, every time, well, all two times, I should say, I come out and I see that it's her. And she's like, I was waving at you for like 5 minutes. And I'm like, first of all, why would you want to wave for 5 minutes when you know there's a bell that is effective? And she was like, you always look straight at me. And I'm like, if anything, I'd see maybe your hand. And if I'm looking in that general direction, also, there's no way you could see me if I'm looking, because you can't see over the thing anyway. But whatever. She's really, really big, and she always gets 10 pounds of shrimp. That's a lot of shrimp.
I know where it goes.
Yeah, between her and one other person. No, I'm not joking. Like, I'm not trying to, like, be mean. She literally says, it's for me and, like, whoever. And I'm like, okay. So,
like, every Friday night, she's lonely and home.
Friday night, I got all this shrimp. Unbeknownst to you, she's giving them names, but it's 9 pounds for her and 1 pound for her cats.
Or her also one big fat cat. So, she's, like, really, like, inadvertently rude. So, like, I understand that it's not on purpose, but, like, she just says mean things. And I'm just like, you're unhealthy. But, anyway, so I recently...
God damn it.
When she recently passed, I end up going to the front. Oh,
okay. I was like, yeah, dude, I got the same thing. When she passed, it was like,
it was a breath of fresh air. But when she came to Super One and like did her thing and went to the front to check out, I actually went to the front and I saw Neva, who's like one of the cashiers that I'm friends with. She goes to UO. I like immediately walked up to start talking about this lady to her to realize that the lady was sitting like to my right, and I'm really glad I had not. So, later I was talking to Neva about, like, this lady and stuff, and her and, like, a lot of other cashiers that they speculate that she just steals everything, because they've seen her multiple times, like, they've never seen her check out, they've only seen her with all her stuff full of bags, but they noticed all the bags are really old looking, so they think, like, she...
Fucking ape.
They speculate chicken. That she like comes in with old bags like hidden under her flaps or something, and she like whips them out when no one's looking, like shoves her stuff in the bag and then just leaves.
Wait, if she doesn't check out, then like, do you think somebody would notice that she's walking out with bags? If none of the cashiers up front checked her out?
No, like they were talking to her with the bags. But like, she already had the bag, so it's not that they can just be like, show me your receipt without any like reason. I mean, technically they could, but
with enough suspicion, they should probably be like, "Hey, can I see your receipt?" Because if this is a common occurrence, and she's just constantly like come and grab shit, then yeah, where the fuck is your receipt,
bitch?
Get the fuck out my store.
We've been on topic today.
I don't know. We've been talking about retail for 30 minutes now.
Is that bad?
No, it's not bad. I'm laughing.
I don't care.
What is on the list this week? I'd like to at least know.
Jacob.
Yo.
Your absence. Speak.
Why?
I wasn't here last time.
Speak about the fact that you actually have a lady.
Yeah, yeah.
But we don't.
I have a lady.
I don't.
What means you
do? Do you? Nope. Okay, 3 out of 5 don't have lady friends.
She was on the one before the last one.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So we just, huh?
So Stephanie went home.
Like that.
Yeah, she went
it's
home.
It's normal.
It's a shame. I mean, she had to go home, but still a shame.
No.
Does she listen?
She has. I don't know if she is right now, though.
If she isn't, she's a bitch. But if she is, I take all that back.
You didn't hear that. You know, she still at least watches on YouTube.
Yeah,
so like,
she's gonna laugh.
You're screwed. You're screwed.
Did she ever find out from, like, that previous podcast that I accidentally spoiled her birthday present?
I told her.
Really?
You told her? So
well,
she didn't...
after her birthday.
So she didn't find out from that. So it wasn't spoiled.
No, I asked her if it was spoiled, and she was like, no, I never saw.
Fuck yeah!
What was the gift?
Oh.
Wait.
Payment onesie. Yeah.
Did you never ask about it? When
no.
You're talking about when he was, like... Jacob was in a onesie recently.
No, apparently
yeah.
I was thinking of Spanker.
Yeah, we're dating now.
No, Stephanie, like, went to get something to eat or something and just, like, wasn't in the room.
The room.
That was so fucking lucky.
But, yeah, like, apparently she was just kind of, like, in and out of, like, paying attention to the podcast.
Good. That's the only time I'm okay with somebody not listening.
Everybody else, you must listen.
But if you pay
attention... Like, the fact that we don't have 300 billion listeners right now, I'm pissed.
Right? I know, like...
How many
why
people
can't
are
we get aliens
planet?
To...
Not 300 billion.
Not 300... I didn't know, I just, like...
transmit the
wait,
signal that this...
How many people
planet?
Are on this planet?
7 billion.
Okay, 7
plus.
Billion people need to be watching right
7
now.
Billion
well,
plus
no,
now?
Shit. Which
no.
Is still.
No.
Where did the 293 billion people come from?
What?
He said 300
oh,
billion people.
Oh, like,
we have 7 billion.
Aliens, man.
Oh,
no,
aliens.
He said 300 billion.
I said billion. I just
oh.
threw a random fucking
you
number
said,
out there.
You said million.
And then
did
I actually
okay.
wondered
we
how many
literally
people.
We could check this later.
Yeah, we could.
It's not that big of a deal.
No,
fight me,
I have a phone number. can I step out for a sec?
No.
I have a phone call.
No.
See, this has to be...
It's up to the master.
Are you actually going to listen and just not go?
It's important. Take your call.
The first one I missed was from Fort Wayne, Indiana. The second one was from some number in Louisiana.
Oh.
I usually ignore
yeah,
all
well,
numbers
you're
I don't
live
have
on a
saved.
Podcast.
That's such a horrible
thing. They should be listening
to
right now.
It is.
Karina does the same thing. Like, she was looking for a job, and I pointed out, what if they've been trying to call you, but because you don't answer phone numbers you don't have saved?
Well, when you're expecting a number that you don't have saved, then that's when you should be wary about it.
Well, I mean,
but if there's like no reason for an unknown number to call you,
but it's completely reasonable for like a workplace to get back to you like weeks later and you've forgotten that you had
I don't
like applied.
I don't have all my brother's phone numbers in my phone.
Brothers?
From my fraternity.
Oh.
I was about to say, I didn't know you had more siblings.
I only have one sibling.
But,
well,
the best numbers to answer. Always.
But yeah, we were with Stephanie. Where did we go from there?
I don't know. We're all over.
The podcast that was mentioned on was the video podcast.
Mm-hmm.
It was episode 10.
Yeah.
So that was like, what, 3 episodes? Because this is 14.
It's been like a month and a half.
Yeah. Well, we actually did like a video one for that one. And at that moment in the podcast,
somebody just linked it, and we have the exact world population right now.
God damn it.
7,331,695. Wait.
You messed up.
Yeah, there's no way.
Okay, 7,331,695,879.
It's counting up. Like, it's going up.
It's going up.
It's going up.
No, it's going up because it's saying that this is how many people are being born right now.
I'm giving birth so fast.
That number's never going to be accurate because you never know when you're going to have like undocumented, like people who are undocumented.
Yeah, that's
just
true.
Off the radar, like
take all of like the wrestling.
It takes
stars,
the average,
children.
I assume. Like,
because like, have y'all heard about like that island off of the coast of Africa where like the inhabitants of are like super duper.
Why
behind?
Would I hear about that?
No, it's just like an interesting fact.
Oh, like they're like technologically in advance.
Well,
yeah, like
I mean, there's places like that all around the world, like in the Amazon rainforest. But when we
those,
say
like those people let you come near,
yeah,
them,
they
like,
at least know other people exist here. The only thing in their world is their island. They don't know anything about the entire rest of the world.
They're super duper aggressive. If boats or airplanes come by, they start shooting arrows and like.
Yeah, they're like, "What the fuck is this shit?"
At least they have arrows, right?
Wait, what? Man, I want to make a joke, and it'd be so good if I remembered it.
Yeah, because, I mean, they wouldn't listen
to the Amish of the world. There it is.
Wait, aren't the Amish the Amish of the world?
No. I was curious about that. I was like, well, they are kind of everywhere anyway. Anyway.
They're the super Amish.
The super Amish.
Their beards are, like, longer, and they're, like, skinnier, and they have more tools.
And,
their beards
and
are yellow.
Hardworking.
And their beards are yellow.
Like, they're so, like, used to manufacturing homes and stuff that they're starting to adapt their own technology. And, like, it's their own.
And
like,
next
instead
thing
of, like,
they're more advanced than
yeah.
us.
Yeah.
It's more advanced than us. And we're like, look, we have a supercomputer. And
no,
they're
but
like,
they're still not,
the
they're
the
still not using electricity or internet or stuff like that. But it's just as advanced. But it's just a word.
Rumspringa!
Yeah! I fucking love that movie.
Rumspringa!
When Amish get Fallout Boy to play for them.
Right? How is that possible in any scenario?
Dude, we need to watch that movie soon.
I was talking to Mike about watching it, and I was like, yeah, it's called Sex Drive. We should watch it. And he just stared at me.
Didn't he think it was, like, about something really weird or something?
He thought it was, like, porn.
Oh.
And I'm like, hey, Mike, you want to watch Sex Drive with me?
It's, like, partially porn.
I don't know. Like,
really.
Not at all. I would just say...
It's about a guy who...
It has
goes
a
long
in the
way for that.
One.
Sex is the goal, but not the journey, I guess.
Yeah. The sex.
Yeah, he falls in love by the end.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's all about the journey, not the goal.
And I think, like, Jacob has made it a point to at least watch that movie, like, once a year.
I've never
more.
Seen that movie.
Accept a rolling brownout.
What the fuck is that?
What about that one guy who always reminded me of Jansen?
Wait, what is a rolling brownout?
What about a peppermint fatty?
Nothing brown, nothing brown.
I like how he was like squirming under her. He's just like, ah.
Nothing you have to
brown.
See it, Matt.
Okay.
You haven't seen it?
I haven't.
No,
either.
I haven't.
Wow.
I don't know how, like...
But for movies that I've seen that y'all might not have, I can honestly say, never go to a donkey show.
Well, what we could do and what we should do is we should just play Sex Drive on the next podcast and just watch and
like commentate.
Don't even comment.
Let's live stream a movie. Just like it's not a podcast. It's yeah. like
and
a,
then we get
it's
taken
like,
down.
It's like a let's watch
movies with Spank.
I think we get shut
let's
down.
Watch?
Yeah,
we'd get taken down
be
so fast.
Yep.
The only place I would work is if like we had a public venue, and like we weren't playing this online, and we weren't like profiting or doing anything with it. It was just like people in the public free.
Mm-hmm. What's the next thing on the list?
Ha ha! Me.
It actually is.
It's
because
Chase, really?
Yeah, Chase partaking in a few Spank and Jake episodes.
Yeah. It's been a few now.
Real like, quick thing. I thought it was really funny whenever Kristen's boyfriend came in right before I left, and he was like, "Dude, I like your videos." And you were like, "What about me?" And he was like, "Who are you?" And you're like, "I'm Jake."
Dude, it felt so awkward because like a little bit after like he mentioned like Spank and Jake, I realized that Kristen and Rachel forced him to watch all of the Awkward Epiphany stuff as well.
Oh,
and like mm-hmm. he recognized me because like I'm the big guy.
Like how you
so,
put that.
Wait. So I'm not recognized from Awkward Epiphany. Yes. Dodge
wait,
that
okay.
bullet.
Chase
oh,
is
wait,
Chase
no,
is
no,
just staring
no,
at him like,
just
dude, what the
literally
fuck?
Literally fucked yourself. You just fucked yourself.
Okay.
You don't want people to watch Awkward Epiphany, and they're all gonna be like,
what the fuck is Awkward Epiphany? Yeah, I gotta check this out.
It's just us
yeah, but
being
isn't
dumb
the isn't
younger.
The whole channel?
I enjoyed
now?
It. Thank you.
You were the only one. Well, you and I, you were the yeah. only ones I ever like appreciated in Awkward Epiphany.
I would have.
That's why I never wanted to do anything because nobody wanted to actually sit there and learn lines. Like everyone was just like improv. Let's say whatever the fuck we want. And then the only good video that ever came out was what? Not improv.
Which one was that one?
The Christmas one.
Video. I don't know.
Yeah.
Timbuk 2.
That was awesome.
Timbuk 2 was not that good.
I know. Shut the fuck up.
One man show, motherfucker.
I handled that by myself. Actually, no. You
self-congratulated.
No, I still to this day think the best one y'all ever did was the Christmas one.
Yeah.
I've seen them all.
That's what I'm saying. Who pretty much all the rest?
I don't know.
That was a group table. Like
the entire thing?
Yeah.
Was it?
Yeah. I remember you, me, and Aaron specifically.
Wasn't it like me and someone else's idea for the, like, hey, let's do this? And then we sat down, like, I remember someone made a basic script. I think it was me and you made, like, a basic idea.
Yeah.
And then we took it to the table.
We've done that
multiple
times.
And we got served.
Where's like, the sand?
We've even...
I think the second best
this
one was
the North
easily...
Well, we even made a skit after Awkward Epiphany that probably nobody has ever seen because it was only used for Rally.
Dude,
oh, you're right.
And it's lost.
You lost it?
No.
How's it
like,
lost?
Yeah,
oh,
no.
It lost as in like the...
No, I got first place and I was supposed to get $100 and I never did. Fucking Miss Sewell.
Fucking Miss Sewell.
Seriously.
Don't talk about Miss Nagy.
What?
Like there was like a rumor.
They were like a thing?
Yeah.
But yeah, that was actually... I liked that a lot.
And like the process...
I need to show you too. You've seen it.
What?
You've seen it, haven't you?
The cat video.
I've seen it.
Yeah,
yes.
I was there. Like,
not sure.
I helped.
Really?
Yeah, remember,
you know what?
I made
you know
a
what
point
means
to be like,
to...
I helped. It was slight, but I helped.
Wait, what did you do?
I don't remember.
But I helped!
Dude, I took a fall for that video.
Dude, you literally took a... I have that.
You have it?
You have that, but not the finished video.
Yes.
Maybe one day we'll just slap it up on the Awkward Epiphany channel and maybe nobody would notice.
Or we can make skits on Spank and Jake and it could just be us.
I've already mentioned like the wanting to do live action stuff on Spank.
I am getting an FL700
like
this month.
Because we don't have all these other people who are like...
interested in it anymore?
Or like involving
fame
themselves.
Fame
thirsty? And like... No, just... It's not just like a... It's a me and him channel. Like before anything, I mean, obviously, like
I was
all
about
the
to say, motherfucker.
You know what I mean?
But
no,
I've mentioned like months ago, like even before like Spank and Jake actually took off, that I've always wanted a group channel where I had a group of people who were just as dedicated as having fun and making content.
So it'd only be three.
I would like. I've always said too, like even back in the Awkward Epiphanies, like I would put a lot of effort into it if. Other
everyone
people were
else
putting
did.
Effort into it.
Who colored that in on the S of Spanky?
Huh? Me.
Motherfucker.
Right now, Chase is mentioning my wall, which has a lot of doodles on it, and there's a giant S, which starts Spanky.
But no, I get the FS700 sometime in August.
Which is a really fancy camera, right?
It's like a $7,000 camera.
How did you get that?
That's literally more than the car that I'm buying.
My school, Full Sail University, which in total I'm paying $64,000 for.
Shout out.
Yeah.
Wait, you don't get SLCC?
No.
Cool.
They sent me this nice laptop, and they're sending me an FS700 camera, which is
can shoot. They just, like,
I mean, you say no. Exactly. Yeah. You say sent. It's $64,000 to attend.
Yeah, it's $64,000 to attend this film school, but they send you all the shit you'll need to start, like, to get your career started.
And you and keep the equipment, right?
So yeah. You're actually going to go to Full Sail.
I already am.
He's doing online.
Oh, okay.
I'm doing the online because, like, I to be able to move there and actually pay for food and shit, like, that's too much. I wouldn't be able to do that.
So, like they're going to be sending, like, I'm assuming each semester you're going to get, like, some new technology or something.
This year, or this semester coming up, so sometime in August, I'll be getting the Sony FS700 sometime next July or June.
That's an expensive camera.
I'm going to get a full sound kit, and then the final semester I get a full lighting kit with, like, 1K watt lights. I think two 1Ks and one 16K.
That's literally, like, 10 times more expensive than my camera.
So, in 4 years...
Wait, we actually have two T3Is.
And I'm still going to be... We can still be using the Rebel T3Is, because, like, this camera is awesome, but, A, we don't have a movable rig that can carry that weight. So, the T3Is are best for, like, the movement shots,
like, most
right?
professional cameras are, like, really big.
Yeah. And you need ginormous rigs.
But I need to
know
how big.
Big enough that you can't carry it with your hand.
Bruh.
It's about
you can't carry it and film effectively.
It's about 1.5 long, about almost 1 foot wide, if I remember correctly from the specs I saw. And then with the lens itself adds an extra, like, foot. And it's in total, like,
I need
30
put that
pounds.
Lens somewhere.
And to be able to, like, move and maneuver it however you need, like, it's almost impossible. So you would need the Canon T3Is, and then one of the Canon T3Is would probably be, like, a dedicated behind-the-scenes camera.
Yeah, I mean, T3I is a really good entry-level DSLR.
Yeah, oh yeah. And then I've got a little handy cam that we can use for, like, head-mounted stuff, or, like, any mounted shots. Like, I saw somebody, they were doing a small little zombie thing, and so what they did was they strapped a bat to a piece of wood, put another piece of wood slightly behind it and angled, and put a little handy cam on it. And that way, when the person went to go hit, like, the stunt person in the face with the bat, you know, not actually hitting them, it has the handy cam tracking the whole shot.
Cool.
So, like, we can use the handy cam for stuff like that, T3Is for the movements, and FS700 for the
fancy shots.
Yeah. Hey. And we can shoot in 4K slow-mo.
Oh, but the with all this talk about, like, new expensive equipment and all this that we already have, would we ever, like, actually take the time to actually utilize them?
What in particular?
Like, the cameras, like, all of our equipment together.
I don't see why not.
You just have to I know there's a whole why not thing, but do we really have a good enough why? Like, are we actually going to sit around, come up with stuff?
God damn it, we've done it before, Spanky.
You just got to fuck.
You and me did, like, this whole team viewer session when we, like, wrote the cat video.
Look, the question is, like, the why, right? And most people within, like, a business sense would say, oh, well, how does it make sense business, right? Are we going to make money from this? Are we going to get enough views from this? But you see, we're not to the point where we need business because we've only got 38 subscribers right now. We're at the point where we can experiment, we can flex around, kind of figure out what exactly we're doing. So the why is literally, why the fuck not? Now, if we have, like, 100,000 plus subscribers, then you ask the whys based on, well, these make just as much money for way less effort. But with the fact that we're not making money from this, why the fuck not? Let's see what we can do.
Well, and with I would say the not being, well, you're not making money from it.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, you never know when it'll pick up. You don't know how long it will take.
Yeah. And I mean, like, if say we got this whole crew together to do a short film, plus the one extra person that's not here that I've worked on, with on multiple occasions. Yes.
Are you sure?
Yeah. He can be serious when he wants to, I swear.
Is it safe to sit like this?
I wouldn't.
And besides, I mean, he's the perfect stuntman. Everybody beats the shit out of him. Anyway, like, once we have the whole group together, like,
a squad,
we could do so much more with a big group and the right technology behind it.
A whole squad.
Exactly. Squad goals.
I mean, I could be sound dude, because
exactly.
I'm going to school for
sound. Sound engineering and everything, and I'm going for digital cinematography and directing.
Could add your sound effects.
He's going for digital graphics, which means graphic design, really cool stuff.
Can do your composing.
And I don't know what y'all are actually going to school for. I can't remember.
Chase wants to be a math teacher.
Motherfucking calculus. Oh, speaking of, so today at work.
I'm going to hate you in a few years. Because you're a calculus teacher. No, I hate pre-calculus. I love actual calculus.
What do you consider pre-calculus?
Like the shit they teach you while you're still in the regular algebra class. Like, it all went over my head, and then I actually got into a calculus class, and I was like, this shit's easy. And then the year before, in the pre-calculus portion of my algebra class, I was like...
But what'd you do? Like, I'm still confused. Because, like, our school didn't have a pre-calc. We went from... We had algebra, geometry, algebra 2, advanced math, calculus. So people talk about pre-calc a lot, and the only, like, thing before calculus is, like, a lot of algebra.
Which, like, I think in Algebra 2, then they cover a little bit of trig.
Yeah.
See, I went to a different school than y'all, so... And that, and it's also been a really fucking long time.
True.
I graduated it when I was 19, I think. I'm about to turn 24, so I can't remember.
One of the meat cutters today made a jab at me, because I held up a country style, which is basically, like, a very cubic piece of meat.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, Michael, this shit's ugly. And, like, he thought I didn't know how to put it into the tray to where it looked nice enough to sell.
Mm-hmm.
And he, like, looked at me, and then he turned around and he's like, you can do calculus, but you can't stick meat in a tray. I'm like, we'll see, motherfucker.
Better step up.
Dude, shove
his ass down.
Okay, so he wants to be a math teacher. What do you want to do, Jake?
Actually, I just took a break. I started a break from school.
Okay, you started a break from school, but which, like...
What was I doing? Going to school
yeah,
for?
What were you going for school for, and what could you possibly be going back for at any point?
How are you helpful to us?
No, I'm just
where
wanting
do
to
you
know.
Fit in?
No, I'm just because wanting to know, not, because it's like...
I'm,
we got on the subject okay, of what am I going for.
Spanky has the ideas. He has the filming equipment. I have the sound expertise. Chase has the ability to come up with a theorem. How perfectly
we have
to work.
Actually,
that's
no.
Economy.
No, like, no.
Economics.
Math is actually a really important part of cinematography due to the fact that you need to know, you know, like, I know the physics behind light, but I don't know the equations behind light. And the equations behind light can tell you what wattage of what light you need for what situation. And
that's
directing.
Physics, though.
Yes, but it's a lot of math stuff. And I don't know how to do fucking math. I hate math.
Chase, it's your job.
He's going to make the next algorithm for YouTube. Like, and base it like to make
everyone
go to us.
Okay, so what were you going to school for?
Psychology.
That's actually also important.
We can understand
we can make
what people want.
Thriller.
You just
well,
spit in
no.
this eye somehow.
Psychological thriller about math.
No, like, film is
will
actually
Jimmy
a...
Will Jimmy finish his calculus final? Or will the ghouls get
well,
him?
I mean,
kill Bill
no,
being a psychology major means you have to be good with people.
Well, it's not just that, but also, like, a lot of film is about misdirection and knowing how people think. So utilizing the idea of how people think in your film can give you the ability to mislead the audience or lead them in the right direction without them knowing they're being led in the right direction.
You know what? All this talk, it makes us seem like a really strong team.
Well, I'd like to not be the math guy. Oh, no, no. Yeah, why can't I be looked
like so bad? We make a video where it's like the slow walk where it's like I'm just walking in like bam, like that person's title.
Oh yeah. The brain. That would be perfect. The brain.
We're forgetting somebody. The tech.
Who are we forgetting?
My brother.
What?
My brother. Gory.
What? We'll dress him up in a Spankeh mascot outfit.
The sloth.
He's gonna do our animations.
You know how to animate?
No.
He's gonna draw us up something.
I can't do that. And I like draw editing. Really. I was the editor first, Matt.
I'm the new one.
Hats off
I'm
to you.
I'm also the new one.
I don't know. All four of us. We've done a fair bit of editing.
The birth of a good idea. We're actually caught on. We've done different kinds of audio editing.
I rely on my Photoshop because I can't do heavy edits like you guys can.
Because
he did. I don't know what you did in like Vegas, really. I don't know. I'm not familiar with.
Well, who the fuck
my YouTube channel actually has all the like different animations or not animations effects I've done. So I'll show you.
I'm just thinking though, like we're also doing a lot more than we had originally planned for with Spankeh back when y'all had originally started recording.
Didn't you like have because a lot less episodes?
Well, yeah, it was going to be 6 videos a week, I think, at most.
It was my idea to like expand.
And
is it
now? Yeah, think, and now like, in this because.
I wanted the podcast from the beginning. Like I started the podcast in January, and we didn't do anything with Spankeh until May.
I think like with this stage of Spankeh, I think doing as much as you possibly can to find a niche would do you well. That way you can find what people like. Niche?
Hey, Travis.
Niche.
Travis, you know what'd be cool?
What? If I shut the fuck up?
No.
I thought
damn,
that's where
dude, why did you go there? That's terrible.
Well, that's where I thought he was going.
No, but anyway, no. But I am gonna scold you. It'd be cool if you like close the back to someone's barbecue boneless whenever.
What the fuck?
That
I
was close to you.
I did close it. What the fuck?
Would you close my fucking food, man?
I don't want it anymore. Like all these little bugs and stuff.
They're fruit flies.
Well, if you don't want it anymore,
you can have it, man.
I'll crack my knuckles at that.
Here you go.
I will eat them as soon as we're done.
So, yes, back to me, because I know I'm so important. I am in the new...
That's the topics
Jacob
list. It's literally
touch
chase,
my
chase, 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 chase,
and chase. No, it's not. Coheed and Cambria?
Yeah, Coheed and Cambria and Fightstar both releasing an album this year and
dude,
in October.
Already heard a Coheed and Cambria song.
Yeah, it wasn't... What's the name of it?
I don't know. It was on
I don't know what Coheed and Cambria is?
Nope.
Really?
You ever heard the song that goes dun 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 dun
dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun dun
I'm imagining the music of my people,
and then it's
and
like,
my people are in Ireland.
We'll show you.
You could have been.
Oh God.
If I had the guitar,
I can play it. Chase can play it.
We can play
it.
We have everybody's playing.
We have the equipment. Let's just like record a cover.
Since I don't listen to either one of those bands, I know Coheed and Cambria's new album's the first album not to be a concept album.
Yeah, like it's just purely
see,
them writing
see, y'all
songs.
Y'all are like excited about music, and I'm excited about one thing. One thing. Metal Gear Phantom Pain. Only a month away.
When you insta jizz and your shirt's on.
That's exactly what's happening. So you're excited too?
Yes, one
more. I'm not the only one.
Did you not hear his
It's like my favorite game series.
You're the only one on Spankeh Jake not excited for it.
Okay, Chase.
And
Chase.
High five.
Wait, before I
fuck forget, Jake
that
too.
That was really loud. That was very cool.
You just called me Jake.
Jake? No.
Oh,
I may be
Jake
too. I meant Jake 2, like Jake 2.0 and Jake 1.0.
I like cake better.
Why not Jacob?
Macy.
We can call you Cakeb.
Cakeb?
Cake.
No.
Okay,
wait.
That's so, Dime, Spanky, right. Jacob, and so Cake.
I was thinking of playing Metal Gear Solid 2 or 3 or Peace Walker.
3.
3? 3 is my favorite.
3 is the best one ever so far.
Just
so
as long as I'm the one playing it, so we can watch how terrible I am.
But 3 is just...
If you want, you can play Phantom Pain on the channel. I have no problem with that. because I want to play it by myself and, like, but go through it, like, nonstop for a month.
I wouldn't do that because Phantom Pain is going to be a really long series if y'all were to do that.
Really?
Yeah, because,
well,
like,
no, just
it's mission-based, yeah?
It's mission-based.
Don't do
based,
all
like,
of the side missions. Just do
okay.
some of them.
There's, like, two maps, but both of them are really big.
Rumored to have a third. Rumored to have a third. A snow map.
I mean,
it's been long rumored for a while, but they're dropping more and more hints, and we're thinking we're going to get at least some sort of a big hint around the corner at Gamescom.
I want a snow level. If Kojima can even say anything. I don't know if Konami's going to even let Kojima.
Kojima could say what he wants. He's leaving in a month.
Conspiracy. Ready? Okay, well, what's his name? I forgot.
Satoru Iwata?
Yes.
Wow.
What?
I was impressed.
He knew. Wait, we're talking about game developers and Satoru Iwata just died.
What if he was, like, gonna speak out, like, in favor of,
Kojima?
Yeah, Kojima. And then, like, they took him out.
Oh my god.
I can't remember exactly who reported on this first, for anybody who is actually interested in the whole Kojima thing. I think it was PlayStation Central had an interview with the composer from Metal Gear Solid, and she stated that she's known, and she speaks Japanese, she's known Kojima for a while, that it's probably all started around the fact that they've been wanting to release this game for a while, but Kojima keeps pushing it back, wanting to make it perfect, and spending just absurd amounts of money to do that.
Have you heard of Destiny?
And well, Konami's not as big as, you know, Bungie and all that, but like, or well, eh. They don't want to spend that much money, and they're wanting him to continue spending as much as he's always spent, but he's spending like reportedly like twice that. Yeah, way over the budget, to the point where for the main composer of Metal Gear, which
Carrie Rex and Williams,
There's a female composer, and she's only composing. She usually composes the whole thing, but she's only composing one song this time. And they went through 35 songs. They fully paid for all 35 of them. He's only using one.
Oh, well.
But he's doing everything. At one point, he even... This isn't confirmed. It's rumored that at one point he pushed the game back because the foliage in the game, all the foliage, was only rendering at 720p. While the rest of the game was rendering at 1080.
Well, I mean,
so instead of release it and patch
reasons,
it,
that's
he said, fuck it, it has to be perfect.
Look, I'd be disappointed if Metal Gear Solid turned into Sonic the Hedgehog.
Well, no,
I'm
like...
I'm sorry to say.
Well, no, like, no games are getting that. Like, even The Witcher 3, which is a phenomenal game, foliage
is
at 720.
Yeah, but that's an actual issue. He's not trying to have that problem. Like,
yeah.
Everyone releases their... They're just like, here! We'll
yeah.
patch it later!
Well, no. Konami's pissed about it. They're like, oh, we're not going to make that much money. Me, personally, I think they're going to send to...
I think it's a good call.
I think they're going to sell 10 million
copies.
The
thing is, like, they're trying to, like, eliminate any mention of Kojima's affiliation with the company.
They're being
so,
very petty about it.
Why? Just because they can't...
They're firing
childish.
Him. They're getting rid of him.
Because Konami owns the IP. So,
and
like,
Konami owns the IP, so they're... pulling his name off the box art, which
from
are
all the games.
Yeah, from all the games. He's still going to be like in the credits at the end of the game, but he's not going to be on the box art, which
Kojima
he's always been.
Not gonna be
Kojima's Productions isn't going to be on there, which has been his company forever. And they're being very petty about it. Like, if whenever they first released, you know, hey, Metal Gear Solid 5 is going to be a thing, if it didn't say Kojima Productions and a Hideo Kojima game, but we all knew he was still working on it, it just wasn't on the box. We'd be like, oh, okay. But now that they're kicking him out and firing him when he's worked on this for like 4 fucking years straight, and now they're just pulling everything from it as if he didn't exist?
I mean,
that seems just really petty when it was there to begin with.
It was the last one.
Yeah, it's the last fucking Metal Gear made by Kojima.
I think another reason they might is because he doesn't want the IP to go on, because like he says, this
what
is gonna be the last
stand
one
for in this case.
Intellectual property.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I'm like, hey.
Sorry.
I mean, like, Konami, because like the Metal Gear is like Konami's only money making game.
Like,
and
games.
Zone of the Enders.
Zone of the Enders hasn't. They haven't released a Zone of the Enders game in over 10 years.
Yu-Gi-Oh.
Well, that's all of Konami. We're just talking Well, Kojima,
recognizable titles. Yeah. Like, I mean, those like Castlevania.
Yeah, yeah. They had Castlevania, but
Silent Hill. But Silent Hill has been dead.
Yeah.
He tried doing
something. That Resurrection it almost had.
The,
Guillermo del Toro and Kojima.
He did post on Twitter,
something.
Both of which have posted on Twitter, that once he leaves, they are interested in working together again. So we might not get a Silent Hill, but we're probably going to get a nice horror game that's going to scare the shit out of everyone.
Okay. I'd have something to say.
Are they going to get Norman's Reedus again?
I hope so.
All right.
I will suck a dick for that.
What?
JK.
Just like earlier, yeah. Man. You don't know. You just gotta try out a dick.
Yeah, we were talking
try
earlier.
Try it out a dick.
In an episode, like.
It's 2015.
Yeah.
You don't
2015,
know if you're gay.
Gay marriage is now legal. Best time to try a dick.
You know, sodomy is still illegal in many states.
So no one's gonna enforce it.
How would you possibly enforce it, sir?
The butthole like, police?
Looks like there's been a dick in this.
he's wearing like a badge, sunglasses, and they have the notepad and a pin.
That episode of South Park where like everyone's bathroom had to like have a security camera installed in it, and like the black police officer was like, "Yeah, I need to check your asshole."
What? Oh my god! I imagine like two butthole police like walking down, like walking through the neighborhood, and they're just like listening. And then when they hear like two male moans at once, they're like, "Oh no!" And they like whip out their guns, they burst through the door, and like, "Sodomy, sodomy!" And they just start firing on their butts.
Okay, you think they just on their butt?
Do you think? No, they fire chastity belts at them.
Shoot out of the guns.
Do you think that when they go to when they go to Butthole Police Academy, that they teach them to like walk like
clench
in a single file.
No. Clench their butts as they
walk. Like every time they take a step, they have to go like.
For what? Wait.
Just because of the butthole police.
So sodomy. Define sodomy for me.
Butt sex.
Yeah. Butt sex, which everyone's been doing since, well, for like the '70s. I'd assume.
No, actually, just
I'm
forever.
Guessing.
Pretty
yeah,
forever.
Yeah, it's a forever.
Everybody's
kind of
thing. Tried, or well,
even Ben Franklin.
I don't know if everybody's tried anal
I don't
sex,
know about
but
Ben Franklin.
But even Ben Franklin.
Okay, so but anal's been around for a while, but it's illegal.
You can't.
Some parts.
You can't.
Some parts
that.
Of anal. It's one thing.
There is like, no way anyone. Would
well, only the
know
tip. The tip
unless,
isn't illegal.
I say most states. I think it's few states. Like
it's
probably
more
like 10 or less.
That just makes
it's
no sense.
It's mostly probably
like,
red states. I'd have to say maybe some blue states.
We live in the reddest of states. Okay, not the reddest.
I think maybe Mississippi.
That thing I was trying to say earlier.
Okay.
Games that I want to get like on the channel as soon as they come out. Okay.
Fallout 4.
Wait.
I like
wait,
how,
wait,
like...
Look. No one's letting
yeah.
me say what I want to say.
Wait.
And also...
I just want to say
like,
thing.
Jacob is, like, top. And, like, we got, like, Matt... Like, Matt, Jake... Whoa, Matt, I
that's
almost
what
called
I thought,
you Jacob.
Oh.
We got Matt, Chase, and Travis just telling you what you
well,
need to put up
no,
there, not what you
I'm
want.
Not, I'm
it's
not okay. saying
listen
you have to.
Audience.
I'm just saying, business sense-wise...
Fallout 4
is huge because so many people are searching it right now. So many people want information about it.
Okay.
That the day it releases,
buy it, and we'll play it.
Okay.
I'm not buying it.
Okay.
There you go. But
I'll
anyway,
buy it.
Games that I am willing to buy that I want to see on the channel upon release because of the same idea. Like, if you put a game up right when it's released, there's a good chance that you'll get more people watching your stuff. All that stuff. Anyway.
Because it's relevant.
Man, I like that goatee you're growing.
Really?
Yeah.
Stop!
No,
I'm trying to finish this.
I love this
game. Okay, we're talking about your beard
I'm
later.
I'm trying to finish
this. We're going to talk about your beard.
Okay, I want you to actually focus on what
yes,
I'm saying.
Yes,
though.
I love
okay.
his hair more, though.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm cutting my hair, too.
Oh.
And I'm trimming this, and I'm cutting this soon.
You just satanic
okay. no.
fuck.
No, just
okay, wait, continue okay. what you're saying.
Okay. Okay.
Did you even say the games yet?
No!
I haven't had the opportunity!
See, look, this is building up.
Shut up, Travis.
Okay.
We're building hype.
Just start naming them.
Okay. I'm not gonna, like, rapid fire them. Okay.
You should.
Like
one.
Sodomy does.
Yes. One. Disgaea 5 in October.
Wow, didn't know that was coming out.
It's coming
cool.
out.
Yeah.
But anyway,
somebody
okay, another one.
Beard.
Star Wars Battlefront.
Someone shocked you
yes.
with a beard.
Yes.
Wait. Jacob has a beard?
Yes,
it's not quite a beard. It's a goatee.
I'm thinking that's Logan or Prudy. It's one of the above. One of the two. It's a wolf gang, so.
But anyway, okay, so this guy of five, Star Wars
Battlefront, which you must.
Call of Duty, Black Ops 3. Don't stick the bird at me. Okay, listen to this. Listen, it's popular as fuck. It's moving to PlayStation for competitive.
Yes, I know.
You see, it's worth.
I get the market value.
What are you
I
moving?
Get
to
the market
like
value.
Exclusive stuff.
Yeah, no. I mean, like, first of all, okay, right now for like the Call of Duty, like all competitive Call of Duty is played on Xbox.
Really?
Oh. And yes, and all like they get all the exclusive stuff first, yeah. Like all the new things they get it before PlayStation.
How,
it's moving to PlayStation.
How are they going to transfer everything? Like, how are they going to?
They're just basically
they're
just
they're
all the exclusives.
Anything,
somewhere
everything
else.
That's
good.
That Xbox had for them, like they're basically, it's like, oh, now PlayStation users are gonna get the updates first, and PlayStation is gonna be the console that is played, like played
that it's developed
Call
for.
Of Duty.
Because yeah. It's always the console that's developed
yeah.
for.
Yeah.
He has an opinion on consoles.
Yeah.
No.
Aww.
My only problem with Call of Duty is the fact that like,
the nation.
They never really have done something that. Super impresses me, like,
really?
Oh, they're putting in wall running finally with this one. Titanfall did that 2 years ago, thanks.
Yeah, but...
Oh, they put in a boost system!
But I don't,
Titanfall
I don't,
already did
I
that,
don't,
too.
I don't know why people complain about Call of Duty because of other games. It's like, so they're trying to... They're not trying to copy games, they're trying to...
I don't know,
like,
I just...
Make people enjoy their game because that's what people like right
now. I've never really enjoyed a Call of Duty game because A, I can tend to get a better experience elsewhere. B, the community is balls terrible.
Well, it's for competitive. No one buys Call of Duty to not talk shit.
How about me?
I just don't talk my time.
Yeah, I don't talk shit to anyone. If I get a headshot, I'm like, wow, I did not that bad right there. That's me. If I get a nice headshot, I'm like,
There are those people.
What is the intended demographic for the Call of Duty games, and what is the actual demographic?
A lot of 12-year-olds having sex with my mom.
It is.
Basically.
Call of Duty is made for competitive Call of Duty. Like, all the other stuff, like leisure players, they can play too, but it is made for competitive play. Like, it's one of those games, like, it's not made... For like
Mario
anything,
Kart.
It's centered around its competitive play. Like everything about the
Fallen
online F. play panders to
yeah,
it.
But I can also get like that same competitiveness from Quake.
Yeah, but,
and that game is over a decade old.
But it's not.
And it's the exact same thing: speed, wall running, double jumping.
But it's a business.
And insane
is what
guns.
I'm saying. It's a business and it's current.
I know. It's a business. It's current. I get it.
Anyway, Logan.
I hate the game.
With your Nay Station.
What is that?
Well, wait.
It's a PlayStation.
He doesn't like PlayStation. He's mad probably because it's moving to PlayStation. Okay, I'll say this, Logan.
He's an ex-boner.
I'll say this, Logan.
Kill him.
Okay.
I don't care.
If this were last generation, I would be upset too. But I love the PlayStation 4 controller, and I think that it could do really well.
Well.
Okay. He says, and I quote, Matt is peaceful, and I'm like, die, you little bitch, I will stab your goddamn eye out.
You little bitch.
See, yes, I am very peaceful.
I am a little bitch.
I'll admit it. Because, like, when I play games like that, I'm like, yeah, I did pretty good. If somebody, like, blows my head off from halfway across the map, I'm like,
that was a nice shot, man.
Yeah, that was a nice shot, dude.
Across the map. Ricochet you know, knife across the map.
When I see that shit, I'm like, well played. You are better than me. I know this. And that's it. But like, if I get a headshot on somebody, they're immediately like, 1v1 me, bitch. 1v1 me. What? You ain't got nothing on me? I fucked your mom. I fucked your dad. I fucked your grandma.
Well, that just
and
goes,
I fucked you too.
That
and it's
just
like,
goes on the community. Just like the YouTube comment section community.
Oh, yeah.
That's the same way. This website, that website, like, it's just, that's just the way it is online.
I used to think, like, I always heard, like, YouTube comments were, like, the worst.
They're the worst.
But I never looked. Like, I never had a reason to look.
No,
yeah.
No,
day,
I can one-up you. I can one-up you.
1v1 me, bitch.
Okay. YouTube, KATC, news, Facebook page, that comment section's toxic.
But that's real, man. That's also closer to home.
That's real, son. But, like, okay, so I never realized, like I said, how bad the YouTube comments were, but I happened to go and look at some comments, and it was a music video. People are stupid.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Like I don't understand it though. Like I feel like
I know.
Well, like when they get to YouTube, their mind just like, my opinion is law.
I mean,
here we go.
Well, that's just like the nature of the internet because, you know,
being anonymous online,
and being able to say anything you want to.
Good loop back, Spanky.
That's just not a bad. That's
well,
just
I got bad. I got a question. So, if we all feel that these, you know, various communities around the internet and around gaming are toxic, well, and we are, you know, trying to establish ourselves as, you know, like a brand and and a platform and whatnot.
Oh, you need to understand. We're going to get shit. Will get shit.
No.
We are getting shit
on
right
I know,
now.
I know that. I know we're going to get shit on.
Logan, he's shitting on me right now.
Am ominous.
You have to develop a thick skin. But my question is, what can we do to change it?
Change what? The culture in general? We can only do our part. We can only not be that way.
Well, no, I'm not saying just that, but like, I don't know, maybe informative videos, short films that like kind of
thing. Like,
I mean, sure.
It'll have limited effect, but it'll have an effect.
It'll have an effect, yes, but enough.
Joined the chat.
It'll never be enough.
We can, like, at least educate our own audience is what
I mean, like, I'm just saying, like,
because you can't take that aspect of the internet away without censoring
stuff.
No,
you can't.
And
but
that's not the right thing to do because when you censor stuff, you're taking away a place where you know people who are going to say horrible things can be. You know where those people are. And by censoring that, you're telling them, well, go somewhere else. We'll be harder to find you.
My question is, with over 7 billion people on this planet,
We found that out earlier.
Yeah. Why does it seem like most of the people on the planet are all douchebags?
Because they are, probably.
Or
they're not.
There's an infinitesimally larger amount of people who are stupid.
Yeah, more misinformed than douchebags.
I feel like, okay, you know how they keep showing those commercials saying that this is the generation where we're going to stop smoking?
Uh-huh.
Right?
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
We need to find the generations that's going to stop the BS on the internet.
Well, here's
just
the thing.
Just people being dickheads for no
reason.
That's
new.
Yeah.
So, like, it's all new to everybody, so how do we deal with it? You know, like, how do you deal with something brand new problem?
Shit gets deep on this podcast.
That's where it might come from, because after some time, that behavior might sift out, and as...
That's just, like,
it
isn't
might
it
come
the
back
root
up,
of, like, cyberbullying, and people are already trying to combat that,
like,
and, like,
it's
not happening.
And reverse bullying, like trolls. Like, I feel like most trolls on the internet are people who get picked on in real life, or who got picked on, who stepped on in real life.
Yeah, I agree.
So, like, they act that way towards people online because they can. They feel powerful.
But I mean,
watch
my
keystrokes, bitch.
1v1 me.
I don't know. It's not that I feel, like, obligated to, we have to fight back. It's just, if everybody knows it's a toxic place.
Well, you just...
Why not fight against it?
It's kind of like going into a bad neighborhood. Certain websites, you know, are...
That's why you don't go into Ildikon,
you just don't look people in the eyes.
Like, you can watch YouTube videos,
just don't
scroll down.
Keep your head
like
high.
Like, if your friend lives in a shady area, Cody, for example, lives in a pretty shady neighborhood. I go there, I'm on my business. The other day, I pulled up to his house, and there's these three dudes, like, smoking cigarettes, sitting in some lawn chairs on his lawn. Don't know who they were, just chilling. And like, I got up and I was like, sup? And I walked over and I'm like, hey, where's Cody? And his roommate's mom was like, they're not here. And I'm like, well, this was a fucking waste of a drive.
But yeah, like, what we can do is try and basically, we don't have to educate people necessarily.
No, you don't have to educate
people.
We
can like present ourselves in a way that would promote people in our comments section to not be dickheads to each other.
Yeah.
What if they feel offended that we're bringing this up?
and they are mean about it.
They feel attacked right now.
That's their problem.
Some people will be.
And then that's when we realize that they're just a bunch of fat fucks.
Yeah.
Fuckhead.
Wait, I thought fat fucks was an endearing term. I'm confused.
I think, like, an important thing to realize is, like, you ought to set the bar high. Like,
you ought to
say, my bar is this high. We'll probably never reach that goal, but at least we're trying. We're striving to do that. Where a problem, I believe, arises is whenever you think, well, yeah, we're going to be the people to eliminate this problem. It'll go away, which is terribly naive thing to say, because all bad things will never go away.
The Holocaust will probably happen again.
You see the
Hitler
ice
still
giants?
Is still alive.
I don't see the ice giants.
The Tesseract will probably
we have
come back
about
for another
10 minutes
Marvel
left.
Movie.
Really? I have a really good question that can make you talk for 10 minutes.
Well, I was going to ask y'all if y'all wanted to go longer.
I don't know.
It's
really fucking hot in here.
Special edition of Spank and Jake.
Quote from Spankeh 2015. I'm actually enjoying this one. I'm actually enjoying a podcast.
This is my 14th.
Usually I would say yes.
It's my 14th podcast and I'm finally having fun.
Usually I would say yes. But it's fucking hot as
you know
balls
why?
In here.
You know why?
What
why?
Do you mean usually?
No
it's
girls.
As hot as
balls. Just boys. Oh yeah.
So do you want to hear a good question?
Yeah.
In fact, I think Logan would be interested in conversing.
Okay.
Conversing.
I almost said conversating like a fucking retard. Anyway.
Conversate.
Nice save.
Thank you. Man, what's that one phrase that's like nice something?
Nice story, bro.
I like his. But anyway,
nice ass. Spanky.
So Spankeh and Matt and Travis.
Yes.
Jacob, I've already talked to you a little bit about it, so you know. But anyway, how would you suggest effectively paying a teacher?
Oh, yeah, we talked. Ooh, we got deep on this too.
Like
I'll let you
guys
see,
like
this,
how would you
this
go
is
about
important to me
cuz
my mom
a teacher and trying to pay them like based off of what? How much should a teacher make and what should it be based off of?
Well, it's kind of unfair to just use, like, the grades from the students.
Yeah.
Because some of them could be, like, excellent students, and then some of them are just rowdy just to be rowdy.
Exactly.
Like, kids are kids.
And then,
so
wait, what'd you do? Then there's the students that cheese it.
I would have a, like, a standard.
They do. It's called Compass.
I don't know this.
It's not, actually. However, it's biased, because in almost all situations, it's your principal going in. You have another person, like, from Compass or, like, from something higher, like the school board, who comes in and observes your class. Howdy. Ha.
Remember, the chat has, like,
oh,
five
no,
or
I,
6 second
no,
lag.
I wasn't thinking of Compass. I was thinking of Common Core.
Yes.
That's what I hate.
Also not that bad, though. Interestingly enough, if you, like, look into it more. But
I don't know.
Anyway.
Like, my mom deals with it, and she, like, she
it's,
just
it's
complains.
Different. That's the problem. Like, especially with math. So, like, it's different for people who are not used to it, but those who are brought up, it's actually the same thing if you think about it, but whatever. Anyway, so, like, of course you say it's unfair to choose the students, because students can literally say, oh, my grades are your pay is based off of my grades. Watch
fuck
me
this
fail
shit.
This test. Like, because they don't care.
I think, I think it should come from both the student's point of view as well as a professional point.
Because
but you have students.
But like this is how I imagine it would
I'm
work.
I'm going to play the devil's advocate the entire time.
But wait, no, because if it was based off the students, like say it was based off our test scores, well guess what? When you're young,
you don't care.
You don't give a shit.
Same thing. So if like say
and
you
if
ask,
it's say it's based off of like an evaluation of the by the student,
they can lie.
They can lie. But say
but
like a college setting where we're grown up, we're mature-er, we're more likely to tell the truth because we know that's the right thing to do.
But also
like,
at the same time, if you're lying, you're fucking your own future because that's what you're going to college for. You're going for your future.
Well, that's if you're in college.
Also, you
we're talking
seen,
about like grade school teachers.
You haven't seen college freshmen, by the way.
No, I've
they're like worse than high school students.
To what Logan said, saying that it's fair because teachers get the summer and holidays off. In many cases, they don't because they stay a couple weeks after summer, like summer begins, like
mm-hmm,
the students
they do.
Let, and then they come back early. Plus,
don't they have to like start lesson plans and all that early?
Yeah, you have to also go in for like
my mom's all
for
in-service.
Workshops.
Yeah.
Workshops and in-service.
And during holidays, you're working. Plus, it's not an 8 hour per day job, because if you're grading papers, you're going home and working more. And even if you just took it like 365 days a year, took your salary, divided up to an hourly wage, if it were 40 hours a week, I think it's less than $30 an hour.
On top of that, isn't
horrible, but I don't know.
Technically, their work week starts with first period, ends with the last period. That's their work day. On average, teachers will get there an hour and a half early and leave an hour and a half to 2 hours late.
Not to mention all the teachers go home and keep working.
Because of the fact that they have to wait for every single student to leave the building.
Don't they also have to pay for a lot of their own resources?
Yes. And if you've ever stayed after any school, like there's usually a bunch of teachers still in their classrooms after
the school day is officially over. My mom pays every year for all of her own markers and crayons and everything. Granted, she's only a librarian at a school that teaches 4-year-olds, but she still has to buy like almost everything. On top of that, like, she starts school, like, I think tomorrow. That's when she's going back to school, because she has to, because at the end of every year, they don't just turn off the lights and lock the door. They completely clean out their entire classroom. My mom had, just 2 months back, cleaned out the entire library. Is going back in tomorrow to put it all back up. And she's not getting paid for any of that until the first day of school.
I don't think that teachers should be paid an outrageous amount of money.
No.
But I think there are definitely some things to be accounted for.
I don't think it's so much the pay. Like, he said, teach what?
Stop shaking the table.
My bad. He pointed out teachers don't do it for the money. Like, especially good ones tend to not to, and I agree. However, I just still think it's, damn it, the way teachers are evaluated in general without taking pay into consideration is bogus.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And, like, there are also just so many, like, things that pull you towards being a bad teacher. Like, you can be a private school teacher and make much more than one from a public school, but you also probably, you're not graded as well, so it kind of, not motivates you, but steers you towards being a much less motivational.
It's like you're easily compliant to just like meeting that bare minimum.
It seems like in this area in particular, like all the good teachers go to private schools. Like,
because they want to get away.
Or it just seems that way because they kick out all the bad students.
Well, the way the system is set up now, from my perspective, it seems like the good get better and the bad get worse.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I think you said that, the first time, too.
And on top of that, for the longest time, they've been met with the type of administration, at least here where we live, the type of administration that is very much like, we're going to cut every single corner we can to not pay for a damn thing.
Dude, education is and like then we're the
gonna
first thing cutting everything, no matter what.
And then we're going to waste money. Our last superintendent wasted a shit ton of money. And the thing was, when he was hired, and this is the most ridiculous thing, when he was hired, he had worked as a superintendent at 3 other school districts in Mississippi and Alabama. Every single one that he had worked at, within 6 months of taking office, they were completely broke because he spent everything. Within 6 months of taking office here, we were completely broke. We had no money for anything. Period.
How does someone do that? And electing these people for these positions.
We don't elect them.
No, but I'm saying, like, these people, these same people, these assholes who have done, like, terrible things and who it's well documented, keep getting, like, their positions.
That's because
keep getting
the reason why
that's because they're politicians. They're politicians doing an educator's job.
They're politicians that's doing an education job. He never, he never taught anywhere, and I think he had never even passed college, and I'm not 100% sure if he passed high school. On top of that, we didn't get a chance to elect him. You don't get a chance. He knows a guy in the room who was able to talk him up to all of his friends, and now they're electing him, and they've never even met the fucking dude.
Sounds like that leader of your
You're in your work, Spanky.
that's like you walking into Washington, D.C. and being like, I know this guy named Matt Taylor. He's awesome. And they put me as the president tomorrow.
Yeah, I know. It's sad
fucking ridiculous.
It's sad that people get positions or like on rank merit. Or this on,
well,
on
not on merit.
On
personal
merit. Knowing a nigga.
On knowing somebody who's willing to talk them up. Not actually.
You're going overtime, like, ladies and gentlemen.
It's like I respect this person, so because I respect this person, and he said, like, sure, this guy's cool, that guy must be cool. Like,
yeah. And it's fucking ridiculous. Now, I think we've gotten rid of him by this point, so that's good. We have, because they actually did an investigation on him, and it pretty much found three things. He's wasting money, he's a douchebag, quite literally. And
literally, he shoves himself into vaginas.
No, no, I'm saying, like, they found multiple cases of him harassing people that are below him. And then they also found multiple cases of him harassing parents. Like the dude that called him out for being a bad superintendent, he fought him.
Put him in jail.
No.
Put him in a hospital.
No, he fought him right in front of the building.
Like fist?
Yeah, like fist fought with him. The cops had to pull them apart. And that's our superintendent. Yeah, that's our superintendent.
I intend to give you a super beater.
Motherfucker.
And it was like... And on top of that, like, yeah, I don't think we should evaluate teachers based on the students. Now, the whole, like, having their superiors go in and evaluate them based on their teaching, their actual skill at the profession, I'm okay with that.
But I don't like
even
how,
my
like,
mom, she gets super stressed out by it because she can't talk in front of people, but she's even okay with
it. As far as being a devil's advocate again. Yeah.
I can see the horns.
Thank you. They can't, but thank you. It's right hard here. To say, stop touching my nipples. In most cases, like, almost all of them are scheduled. Like, mm-hmm. Hey, I will be coming in.
No,
and
only one. They get two per year. The first one is scheduled. They know the exact day. And then, at least this is how it's worked with all the teachers at Truman Montessori School. And the second one, they say, it's going to be between this month and this month. And it's usually like a 3-month gap. It's going to be in spring at some point. And so, they give you some warning as to what season it's going to be. But that pretty much just says, okay, it's not going to be in January.
I don't.
And
like
that's
how,
all they'll do for the second.
I don't like how it's just the principal.
Well, it's the.
It's not.
It's
not.
It's no, not. The one that is scheduled, like mm-hmm. the exact day, is the principal.
Uh-huh.
The one that's a mystery is the
also
person
a
who
woman.
is a mystery person who works like at the office, who is like their supervisor, and it's not like somebody they know, because my mom's been a teacher for well over 30 years now. She actually retires today, and she's starting her 3 years of drop this year. She's seen the woman who is higher up than her, who's worked there just as long as her, 5 times. And it's all been since they started the evaluation.
Does anyone else not like No Child Left Behind?
Oh, I hate that shit.
Did you know Obama revamped it?
He revamped
really?
It?
Yes.
How did he change it? I didn't hear about
it
that.
It was very minor, to be honest.
Uh-huh.
It was basically just keeping it in play. Changing a few things. I learned about it in my first EDFL class. Honestly, I don't remember too many things. However, the changes that he did make were good. But overall, it's still... Like, I don't know. It's a good concept. Like, it's good to try to keep everyone on par. But in so many ways, it limits really good students just... So the slower ones can keep up, and like I don't like that.
The thing is that we're trying to get people, especially people who come from disturbed backgrounds of some sorts, where you just don't want to. You're
they
trying
don't
to make
label
them,
any of them.
He got onto trying, his own thing.
Yeah.
You're trying to you know teach them at the same pace that everyone else who is doing good. You know, you're trying to teach them at that pace when it's clearly not working. You know. There should be some kind of.
Is there like an actual problem where like the higher like intelligent students are being stagnated because the slower ones
they'll dumb down the curriculum to make sure that the dumber students pass.
Okay, for example, Miss McCann's class.
Then that kind of feels like that's why AP exists. But then, like, once, like...
But how prevalent is AP here, at least?
Yeah, where do we have any AP classes?
Technically.
Technically.
Isn't it technically required, like, to have at least, like, a couple?
But it's... But like, our calculus class was considered an AP class. That was the only AP math, and that was only because it's the next math course.
I think... Yeah. What?
I was the same thing at Acadiana.
What schools should be doing is holding their teachers to a higher standard. Because if I had a good teacher, I always love learning with a good teacher.
But at this
it makes
point,
me excited to learn, and it makes anyone excited to learn, especially if someone of good.
It's the how to implement that higher standard, because
I heard
somebody say this, and I find it really great. Is teacher accountability wonderful? Not wanting to leave a child abandoned. Wonderful. How to implement it? Well, how it's been implemented so far?
Not
wonderful.
But
we all want it, but we don't know how to do it.
One thing I think schools, especially around here, could do as far as like trying to get, you know, the students that are lacking to.
Why not just take the previous year grades and just kind of like.
That's called tracking, and you're not allowed to do it in the United States.
Okay, I learned something new today.
Yeah, because I asked that to my counselor, Miss Miss Harrington, and like she explained a lot to me that they do it in like European countries, and it's basically like, we know that you're probably not college bound. We're gonna put you on these easier classes so the college bound students can learn more. You will still also learn at your own pace, so you don't have to. You don't feel like uncomfortable. Blah,
yeah, but
blah.
What if like the system like with that like that student starts like advancing or like having such good grades that maybe they can be bumped back up into that other.
That's kind of the reason they can't. Like that's why there's no tracking, because it's unfair. And like, what if some do want to and they just kind of can't? And they feel demotivated because they know, like,
that
oh,
is
look.
The case, though, in the United
yeah,
States,
but
even.
There are some students
with
that are like
people.
That. They may have, like, a learning disability or they're having trouble in some areas.
Well, there's a difference between a learning disability and just having bad grades.
Yeah.
Like, they have specialty classes for, like, remedial things, and that's one thing. But I'm talking about they will, like, literally say, you don't even need to take algebra. You don't need even to take this because you probably won't use it. Blah, blah, blah. Things
oh,
like
when
that.
People aren't even given
the
opportunity, you mean?
Yes.
I didn't graduate from the normal type of high school. I graduated from a place called Charter where, because I was having trouble in the higher maths because I'm just naturally shit at math, because they would spend all this time on the easy stuff that everybody gets, right? What is X equal? Well, that doesn't take long to fucking figure out. But then, like, the pre-calculus stuff and some of the trig stuff, they just blow through really fast because they're like, shit, we have to cover all of this by the end of the year, and we spent so much time on that. But whenever I got to Charter, they said, here's the teacher, here's all of your curriculum, do it at your own pace. The teacher is going to make sure you are never stuck and you are never wondering what the fuck is going on. And we have three tutors for the entire class.
And I mean,
and I went from making nothing but F's in math
to nothing but A's
to making a 4.0.
Neat.
Yeah. Balls, so it's I don't know, sometimes students just some people just have problems in certain areas. Like I've never studied for an English test, I've never studied for a science test, and I've never studied for a history test. I've never failed any of those three. But I can study as much as I want and I'll never pass a fucking math test. Or at least I have trouble with it.
I find math... Hold on one second, sorry. I find math to be a... You have to have a really good foundation or you're fucked. Because, like, Karina was really, really bad at math.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, I'll try to help you. And now she is just fine at it. Like, going into it, she was very wobbly... whatever.
So you're already
shaky
being a teacher. Wow.
With algebra. But I was like, this. And, like, re-explaining... She didn't get it, re-explained in a different way. Then she's like, okay, why didn't they just do this in the first place? I'm like, because they don't, like, it is hard, though, to teach to every student's liking, which is why what you brought up about the charter school, it's nice. However, not all are like that either.
No.
But in that situation, it reminds me a lot of, like, our Algebra 1 class. He's like, okay, this is what you're going to be doing for the next 6 weeks. As long as you get it done in 6 weeks, awesome. I'm grading it all. If you finish it all in a week, good. You can get on coolmath.com and play games. Like, that's literally what he did for us. So everyone was moving at their own pace every 6 weeks.
So dude, everyone, that sounds wonderful.
Yeah, and he, like, went around all class period. Those who got it were chilling, doing the work. Those who were disrupting, he'd be like, hey, stop. And those who needed help, he'd help them. That simple. But it takes a lot of work. And people like him and people like my American history teacher, they put in so many more hours than 40 hours a week to work. But it amounts to nothing almost. Yeah, they care, and that's awesome. But, like,
it doesn't mean anything.
It doesn't mean anything to anyone else, except, like, some of the students who actually realize to them how much and the students. How important that is.
Because, I mean, like, I know I appreciate Mr. Nagy, because I wasn't good at math.
He was a boss.
Dude, he cared about me. Like, he got on me for, like, making an F in art because I just wasn't doing my projects at one point.
During my senior year, his class was... My math class was my first class.
Him. Yeah, you missed that, man.
Yeah, I missed Soul, and then I failed Algebra 1.
Well, they were doing it, so.
See you, Logan.
Another thing,
hi, Logan.
I think.
He's probably already gone.
Whenever cuts need to be made, it shouldn't be for who's being hired to educate. Because I think that's what happens when they fucking start putting gym teachers, physical education teachers.
Yeah, my PE teacher was a chemistry teacher, and I asked him one day.
That's because there aren't enough science and math teachers. And as far as social studies teachers, there's like almost even less.
Well, I asked my chemistry teacher, like, you're a PE teacher, do you even have, like, any kind of special education in chemistry? And he's like, I took high school chemistry.
You know, and, like,
and I'm like, that's reassuring.
When I was a sophomore, my civics teacher...
And that was, and like, and he was like 58.
This is coming...
He had no memory of it.
This is coming from someone who thinks civics is something that should be instilled in people, especially in the United States.
I don't remember anything about civics.
And our fucking civics teacher that teaches you about how the United States government works was the fucking basketball coach.
Dude, all he did was say, like, oh, you smoking that wacky debacky?
Like, I don't know.
No, my civics teacher, I would be like you when I grow up. He would sit there and he would do anything. Like me, I got civics really easily. Right?
Like,
but so I was able to fuck around and play on my Game Boy. But, like, for the people that was having trouble, like, he went to the point where he came back to school
one
day,
but, like, it wasn't,
and he was like, for all the people who are having trouble with it, I made a rap. And he's like, he said he spent all night making a rap specifically to get the students who didn't fucking get it about how the judicial system works.
Speaking of music and civics,
that Bill song.
Yeah, but no. Miss Broussard, my civics teacher, she was just like, okay, you have to make, like, a presentation, do something with, like, an amendment. You pick any amendment you want. And we got grouped up in the teams. Well, I ended up getting Moody, well, Kendall, and Jarrett. And we decided that, I'm going to do, like, a slideshow. And Kendall was just like, I'm going to make a song. So we made a song for Amendment Number 9. Do you know what Amendment Number 9 is?
What?
Freedom of expression.
Motherfucker.
That sounds like deep as shit.
That would be irony.
Huh?
That would be irony.
Okay, well.
That sounds deep as shit.
So we were just singing, like, he, like, actually, like, made this whole song about, like, being able to say what you want, which is covered under free speech, but, like, dress how you want, how, like, listen to whatever you want. And stuff like that. It was pretty cool. Dude, if I can get the chorus, you guys would, like, find it cheesy and adorable.
I've heard it.
Have you heard it?
Yeah.
Why?
You showed it to me.
Did I?
Like, a long time ago.
I think we should probably.
Like, I remember my senior year, Miss Broussard was just like, I show my other classes that song, and I'm just like,
damn.
You probably shouldn't.
my speech teacher still admitted, like, right before she retired last year, that she was still showing my monologue to people.
Cool.
Because I started,
I bet that hat flapping.
I started it out by mic, like, laying on stage, and, like, it was all about people chasing their dreams. I'm like, she's still
don't
let your dreams be dreams.
You said tomorrow, yesterday.
Just do it!
This has been
the
podcast.
No.
I think that's an interesting note to end this episode.
No, I have a question. Sit down.
Stand
I have one
your
question.
Ass up.
Okay.
Okay.
Bitch.
What would you name this group?
the five of us, what would you name us?
Five Guys Burgers and Fries.
Without copyright.
Spank and Jake and Three Guys.
Spank and Jake plus three.
Spank and Jake plus three Jake.
Why can't my name be in it?
Oh.
Spank Chase, Matt.
The Jacob, Jacob, and Spanky and two other show.
Oh, Spank and Jake and the Sidekicks.
Spank and Jake, Spank and Jake plus.
I like that.
Why does it have to be a Spank and Jake, though?
Because that's how it started.
Okay, Travis and Chase.
No, like me, I don't give a shit.
That's if it's what I was leaning towards, yeah. Like a whole fresh name. Because I understand Spank and Jake as a me and Jacob kind of thing.
Why does this group need a fresh name?
Yeah.
Because, like, the five of us can't all just be under the name of two people.
No, you don't understand. Why is this a thing?
I was just like,
can I throw something out there?
I got it. Owl pendant.
Wait.
Owl pendant.
No. Fuck
the, that, what the fuck?
No, I don't know.
That'd be okay. Me and Spanky only, then.
Okay, yeah. Look.
Ah, fuck.
Look.
Like, me and Chase are Team
me
Owl.
Me and Dylan, a while back, figured out, and we already checked the copyright on this, nobody else has a company named this, but we eventually are going to start our own company called Limited Edition Productions. And...
No, that's
y'all
cheap.
Could use that name.
That's cheap.
Semi-limited.
Semi-limited.
Kind of not that limited, but still kind of limited.
We're going to make the company Limited Edition Productions, and we're going to do short films through it.
Semi-limited could be like an underling production.
You know how Matt and Dylan are Limited Edition, and we're Spank and Jake?
Uh-huh.
We should make Unlimited Edition.
Big Test Icicles.
No.
Best Test Icicles.
Wait, what's the combination of the two?
What is...
Limited Scared Spank. Hitless.
Limited
Spank.
Spank. Spank and Jake Unlimited.
No, look.
Oh, man.
See, I don't care if it says...
Want to talk about this, like, after the podcast? Or
yeah, let's go ahead.
We're
going to
brainstorm and come back next.
This is the conclusion of this special long edition of Spank and Jake.
We're all fucking confused.
Is the name of it, by the way.
I'm sorry. The Hey We're Friends podcast. This is the special long edition. I'm Travis. That's Spanky. That's Jacob. That's Chase. And there's
no,
Matt.
I'm Jacob too.
To my Jacob, left and to Jacob. My right. You are a Jacob. You're a Jacob. You get a Jacob. I get a Jacob.
I don't want to be Jacob. He sucks.
He literally went, you get a Jacob. I get a
so
Jacob.
So we're taking...
I want to thank everybody for listening to the podcast.
Thank you everybody for listening to the podcast. You're welcome, Spanky.
Okay, fine.
You're welcome.
Bye, guys.
Drop a like, drop a comment. If you like it, it's cool. Subscribe to not this, but Spank and Jake. See, I plugged you guys. Don't hurt me.
Why would I hurt you?
And
stop. Yes,
press
stop. Bye.
Whatever's to come soon.